Hi guys, this is Tanu and welcome back to my channel. So for today, I have planned to show you some killer workouts on abs, and this word sounds like a magic, right? The dream of washboard abs is probably the ultimate reason of performing ab workouts. But a strong core doesn't just look good, it benefits your health in a number of ways. Core training improves your performance in any kind of sports. A strong core helps you avoid injuries and makes your movements more efficient. This training program can both prevent and control your lower back pain. A strong core improves your posture and stability. Ab workouts strengthen your torso and help to provide a stable base for lifting. That means it improves your ability to bear more weight. Ab workouts help in reducing body fat, a problem associated with many lifestyle diseases such as obesity and diabetes. By increasing muscle mass in the abdominal region, the body metabolism increases and more fats are burned. And this leads to a slimmer, trimmer and leaner body. So the bottom line is, the stronger the abs, the stronger the support. So, without doing further ado, let's get started. Crunch is a classic core workout. It specifically trains your abdominal muscles, which are part of your core. Your core consists not only your abs, it also includes your oblique muscles on the sides of your trunk, as well as the muscles in your pelvis, lower back and hips. Together, these muscles help stabilize your body. Lie down on your back, plant your feet on the floor, hip width apart, bend your knees and place your arms across your chest. Contract your abs and inhale. Exhale and lift your upper body, keeping your head and neck relaxed. Inhale and return to the starting position. Many of us equate core strength with a flat belly or six-pack abs. And while those may be motivating goals to you, there are so many more benefits that come from improving core strength than how your midsection looks, including improved posture, better balance, reduced back pain, and easier breathing. This workout increases core strength in the obliques and the rectus abdominis. It engages upper back muscles and great beginner exercise for targeting obliques. Rectus abdominis contract isometrically while obliques contract dynamically. Start by lying down on your back on a mat. Bend your knees and position your arms straight on the sides and maintain your feet and your back flat on the surface. Lift your upper back forward and crunch to the right side and touch your right heel with your right hand and pause for 2 seconds. Slowly return to the initial position and repeat the procedure on the left side. Sit down on the floor with both your knees slightly bent. Touch the floor with your heels and position them around a foot or so from your butt. Lean back until you feel your abs engaging to help stabilize your body. The more you lean back, the harder you work. Do not round your back. Keep it straight. Hold your arms straight out in front of you or hold a dumbbell, a plate or a medicinal ball. Take a deep breath and pull your navel slowly, steadily towards your spine and twist slowly to one side and then the other, rotating as far as possible. Don't hold your breath, instead maintain a steady breathing rhythm. Allow the abs to do the work, not your arms. This is an effective way to target the rectus abdominis, external obliques, internal obliques and hip flexors while improving core and trunk balance. You are not alone if you are unable to do more than 10 to 12 of the exercise before you reach failure. Feeling the burn means the exercise is working. Building your core strength, balance and coordination can help you maintain good posture, catch yourself to avoid falls and perform better at a variety of physical activities. This super basic move is packed with so many benefits and is a staple in HIIT and strength training workouts. Start in high plank position with hands directly under your shoulders and legs extended behind you. Tuck tailbone in as you engage core muscles. Push floor away from you and look diagonally ahead. Your body should be in a straight line. Bend one knee and draw it to chest, then straighten behind you. Repeat on the other side, alternating without stopping. Prevent hips from shifting by contracting your midsection and glutes. Your hands are placed comfortably on the ground. Your feet are hip width apart. You should be balancing on the balls of your feet. Your spine is totally straight. Your tailbone should be tucked so that it's aligned with your spine, not sticking into the air. Your glutes, butt muscles are squeezed tight. Your belly button is drawn in toward your spine. Your lats, back muscles should be flexed and pulling away from the floor. Your body is in one straight line and make sure your lower back isn't snagging and your booty isn't popping up. Try to hold the plank for 30 to 60 seconds at a time. This exercise fully engages the abdominal wall and helps to tone your abs, trims down your waist and strengthens your core. This exercise also helps to improve your posture, flexibility and balance. Lie on your back and lift your legs until they are perpendicular to the floor. Extend your arms and lift your shoulders off the floor. And try touching your feet with the arms. Return to the starting position and repeat. Contract your core muscles, drawing in your abdomen to stabilize your spine. Exhale and slowly at first go through a bicycle pedal motion, bringing one knee up towards your armpit while straightening the other leg, keeping both elevated higher than your hips. Rotate your torso so you can touch your elbow to the opposite knee as it comes up. Alternate to twist to the other side while drawing that knee towards your armpit and the other leg extended until your elbow touches the alternate knee. Aim for 12 to 20 repetitions and 3 sets. It helps to promote a good posture, can reduce stress, intense core workout and strengthens the muscles in the abdomen, arms, chest, legs and back. Improves your stability and balance. So start in a low plank position with your body in a straight line, your elbows bent and under your shoulders and with your feet hip width apart. Bring your right knee to your right elbow, extend your right leg back and return to the starting position and repeat on the left side. It's a balancing exercise and you will be building your balance and coordination. This exercise can help you be able to sustain good posture and ease of movement by building a strong core and better balance. Lie on your right side, legs extended and stacked from hip to feet. The elbow of your right arm is directly under your shoulder. Ensure your head is directly in line with your spine. Your left arm can be aligned along the left side of your body. Engage your abdominal muscles, drawing your navel toward your spine. Lift your hips and knees from the mat while exhaling. Your torso is straight in line with no sagging or bending. Hold the position. After several breaths, inhale and return to the starting position. The goal should be hold for 60 seconds. Change sides and repeat. These are classic abdominal exercises done by lying on your back and lifting your torso. They use your body weight to strengthen and tone the core stabilizing abdominal muscles. With a larger range of motion, they target more muscles than crunches and static core exercises. This makes them an ideal addition to your fitness program. Exhale as you lift your upper body up toward your thighs and inhale as you slowly lower yourself back down to the floor. Guys, I hope that now you understand that a strong core, you know, those muscles around your midsection, can be a ticket to feeling and looking best, even if you don't reach the six-pack status. I hope you guys found this video helpful and please give it a thumbs up if you like this video and also share with your friends and family and make them realize the importance of a strong core in our everyday life. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel, guys. Keep coming back to my channel. I'll see you in my next video. Till then, take care.